It doesn't do anything. I figured it might open another door back there or something. I'm missing something, obviously, because we're supposed to find out the secret. An unusual door, but it doesn't hold any secrets. Looking. Is this back where I think it is? Yeah. Which way? The way up, yeah. Oh, that's... never mind. So that goes down. This is a dead end. Let me just check it again. Yeah. Let's just check here. Nope. Dead end though. The bottle though. I wonder about that bottle. That goes down, dead end, clicking, huh. I've been all over here. Clicking these walls. I'm too far away. For what? Huh. Checking all these walls. Check these. No, this just goes up to that. It ends in a room? Oh, it ends here. Well, it doesn't end, but... still checking all these rooms. Click, 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 click. Now we're back to the main floor. Kinda crazy. I mean, the dungeon, all in all, isn't really that big. But it's not giving me the answers which I seek. Huh. I'm so glad, guys, I found it. It's in here. A warrior ran up from here. I thought it killed everyone, though. I guess they randomly come back. He ran from this way, which made me think that he didn't come out of here, but evidently I did not go in there. But it made me think that I haven't explored everything, but I think the only place I haven't been is here. You pick up a death certificate. I'm excited. I was really afraid because I heard that there was a bug with this quest where the death certificate either would be in an area you couldn't get through, so you had to try to clip through the walls to find it, or would not just appear in the dungeon. Because in classic Daggerfall, it goes in either one of two dungeons. Daggerfall Unity made it a random dungeon, like this dungeon type, which is supposed to be have undead, but I didn't find any undead, so there's another error or something they changed their mind about. Either way. So I was like, is it bugged? Because you never know. No, it was me. It's down the bottom then. Yeah. Okay. Quite a read. Oh, I can go. Okay. Oh, you click. Okay, wait a second. You click through it, you don't. Alright, never mind. I was trying to, like, mouse wheel up and down. 23 Morning Star, 3rd Era 400, the Wrathom Ruins. 2 days I was sealed within this crypt without food or water. See, it's not really a crypt. We found warriors here, spiders, and orcs. And one bat. I don't remember coming across any undead. I do not know whether hunger or poor health or one of the creatures who share this dank hole with me will kill me first. I only know that I will soon be dead, and not even my bones will remain. Oh, I auto-corrected it in my head. My hope is that in the years that come, this letter will be read and the sad story of Lugar, Prince of Sentinel, will be told. I am 15 years old at the time of this writing, and have been plagued with bad health for most of my life, to the frustration of my hardy parents. That's how sad, only 15. The finest healers and apothecaries. Right, so he's older, I think. So then Prince Lhotun is somewhere around 5, because I think he said he was 10 or 11 years older. That Lugar was 10 or 15 years old. 10 or 11 years older, but didn't know which. The finest healers and apothecaries in Western Tamriel have labored over my every cough and fever. But while they could save my life time and time again, they could not improve my sickly constitution. In retrospect, I received little real affection from the king and queen. Embarrassed as they were about begetting such a cripple as the heir of the kingdom, I cannot say I missed the love. I received much attention from the doctors, priests, and herbalists constantly at court. Certainly, I was not to be the sort of warrior that King Cameron was, but one of my dearest friends, a prince of Stendar, said that I might be the first scholar king in the history of Sentinel. My younger sister, Aubki, I hate that saying that name, was the true favorite of my parents, athletic, beautiful, and charming. It is hard to think of an uncomplimentary word for her. I am resigned to my imminent death, and yet I would like to see her once again. For 6 years, Aubki and I were the only children of Sentinel. 8 years ago, the queen had a boy child and named him Greklith, after the ancient Redguard word for strong king. Greklith. So 8 years ago, so Greklith was 7 then, at the time of this writing. Few speak that tongue any longer, and all the scholars and nobles of Hammerfell understood, and Greklith is a strong boy indeed. I have never so much as seen him cough. The queen's next child, born only a year after Greklith, so 7 years. So they're not as far apart. They're like 8 years apart. Or 7 years apart. The queen's next child, born only a year after Greklith, had an even more ominous birth name, Lhotun. Second boy. Oh my god. They don't even count him as a boy. Huh. Poor kid. Perhaps had I been less sheltered, more suspicious by nature, I might have read into these nominations. Lhotun and Greklith are common enough names in our family, I reasoned. Now I know that even then I was disinherited, even if it was not official yet. For several months before Lhotun's birth, and over 3 years afterward, I was in the throes of a very serious fever. The doctors despaired of me, but somehow, and very, very gradually, I recovered. For the first time, and the last, I read an expression on my father, the king's face, that was not indifference, it was disgust. Jeez. These people are horrible. Your kid's sick, it's not his fault. That was a fortnight ago. 3 nights ago, I was seized by men I had never seen while I was having a walk. My nursemaid stood by, watching placidly as I was gagged and tied and thrown roughly into a sack. I do not know how long they rode with me, but I was eventually left here. When I finally freed myself from my bonds, I found that I was alone. My wanderers have gotten me nowhere. This place is filled with undead creatures that prevent me from finding any exit. Well, maybe the warriors and the orcs killed the undead creatures. I have no hope left, but no fear either. A few regrets. Perhaps had I studied magic instead of history and science, I could have freed myself. I could free myself of this place. One of my tutors told the story of the Underking, how he had placed his life force in the body of a powerful being and had thus conquered all Tamriel long, long ago. Had I only the strength of a more powerful body like that. But I did not study magic, I studied history, so I leave this letter, not to revenge myself, but as an historic document. Damn. This poor kid. Alright. I'm glad we finally found it, though. There's no door here. So it was right near, because I was clicking this, and then the warrior came from here, and I'm like, did I explore this area? And I popped in here. So I guess I did not go in here. Probably distracted by the box. Alright, so I want to teleport back. Done. So now we have to return to Sentinel. This time we're actually going back to Sentinel. Begin. It worked. The city streets are really well maintained and clean. Someone's praying again. Okay. So we need to get back to the palace, which is up that way. So I'm excited to see what Prince Lhotun might have to say about King Lysandus then. Hopefully he'll tell us something very useful, because I had a lot of trouble finding this death certificate. Oh, sweet, I like that. The bridge between buildings here. I think there's a door up there. I haven't practiced my climbing for a while. There's even... Oh, Sentinel City Walls. This goes into the city walls. That's interesting. The mouse and fawn. Huh. That's cool. The inn is connected to the city walls here. But how's that a city wall? The wall's over here. Wow. We can see it all, baby. Just a small owie. I come with news. So that's pretty cool. We found out what we wanted to find out in the messenger had a very clear motivation, wanted to make sure that the Underking was not or no longer being blamed for the death of Lugar. Greetings. Every time I click him, you hear that. This what I most feared, poor Lugar. As I promised, here's what I've heard about Lysandus. I don't know how much of this is secret, but I trust you. Lysandus was in love with his court sorceress, a noblewoman named Medora Dereni, and during the war with us, his queen found out. They say that while her husband was gone, Queen Minisera banished Medora from the court. My sister, Obki, is queen now. Not part of the treaty to ensure peace, but Minisera still resides at Castle Daggerfall as a Dowager Queen Mother. I don't know where Medora went, but I know she has an enormous castle somewhere in the Isle of Balfiera. But I also heard that there is some kind of curse on her and she can never leave. I don't know if that helps you, but that's all I know. Again, thank you for Lugar's letter. Just knowing what happened will ease my heart somewhat. Please take this longbow as a token of my appreciation. So, Queen Minisera banished Medora from the court. It won't be fun to find this Medora, Dereni. On the Isle of Balfiera. I was looking at that island a couple episodes ago. She can never leave. An enormous castle. So... Also, I could also try talking to Queen Minisera or Obki. Minisera is at Castle Daggerfall. Magical longbow. Thank you. That's that. I clicked on it again. Okay. Well, I want to identify this thing. Steel longbow of featherweight. Cast when used, slow falling. I guess not when fired, but it also has that power. That's a pretty cool one, though. So I could use my actual... I get rid of this longbow and use that one. Might as well. They're both steel. Now, I wonder if I can go back here, because the queen here is somewhere back here. Not sure if we're allowed back here. If they start coming after us, I'm just gonna restore. The guard by the door intones in a bored voice, "All those having business with Queen Alcarithi, pass through the door at the back of the hall on the right-hand side." Does that mean we're not supposed to be in here? Bush? Oh, he makes that sound too. Interesting. Yeah, I'd like to talk to her while I'm here. Oh! Alright. I am restoring the right side. He said the right side. Greetings, Lord Kavar? Caviar? Oh. Sorry. Oh my. I despise your kind. Just go away. Oh. The kind that has clothes. Oh, did I went left, didn't I? No. No, I went right. This is the right door. Am I, like, in steel mode or something? I don't want them after me. Does that happen because I'm clicking on him? Yeah, it must be in steel mode. I'm gonna be in like... Oops. Okay, I had like a blank screen there. Dialogue mode. Okay. But he told me to go to the right. I did not see her. I'll pass through the door at the back of the hall. Well, that's that. I'm gonna look there, but I just want to see if I can look around in here as well. There's a half-naked guy in here. Catharn? I don't have time for your type? Okay. Brithka? Why would I help a complete stranger, especially one with your reputation? Cernum. Good day to me. Alright, so he said the back of the hall, and then the other guy gave me further instructions. Oh, we didn't go through this door, though. I just want to see what there is. Sarir. So it is this one. So from here, I guess at the back of the hall on the right hand side. Well, this isn't a hall. So this is the right hand side? Oh, maybe this one. Oh, really? Whoa. That's a fast one. So she's up here? Probably doesn't have anything to say to me. She might give me a quest or something. Oh, wow. Really? So we have a whole separate court here. Ash. Oh, Matt Stranger. Lowit. These are consorts of the Queen, I suppose. Need something? Sound familiar. There's another door there. Queen? Oh, cool looking. Queen Akarithi. She doesn't speak. Oh, there's Grekleth. The other one. Infomo, they don't speak. Okay. Well, they might have a quest for me at one point. I'll try to remember. This is the way through. To Star. Alright. Oh my. Well met, huh? Well met. Interesting. Assembly of people you have here. There's another door. Hopefully people are comfortable. Hopefully it's warm up here. Well, she's well protected up here, I'm guessing. It's a very fast moving floor here, or platform. And then here, I've been in here. There's a door on the other side. Was a little kid. I've heard of you. Nothing good, of course. Get lost. So this is where you start hating kids in Elder Scrolls games. The tradition is carried well into Skyrim, but it started here. Okay. So I might just want to go to Daggerfall and talk to Minisera, is it? Or Aukby. Yeah. So I forget who told me. I think it was Princess Morgiaya. Says, get in good with Minisera, the former The former queen, who is the former queen of Daggerfall and queen mother to Gothred, I should speak with somebody of lower station. So, most probably have to fulfill a quest from somebody in the Castle Daggerfall. And then I can go talk to Minasera, possibly. If she's still there, otherwise I'll find out where she is. Well, maybe at that point I could talk to either Gothred or Abki. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.